Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to ESL One Cologne 2014. As you just saw, Dignitas celebrating their win in their quarterfinal, richly deserved win in two maps, and going through to another semi-final at a major event. Let's take a look at the bracket and show you where we are right now in terms of ESL One Cologne. Two teams already through, Fnatic and Dignitas. We now move to the lower half of the bracket and we concentrate on our last four teams. Just two spots remaining in the semi-finals. Time to introduce you now to our next two teams. It's almost sad that we're halfway through the day already after some fantastic Counter-Strike, but the good news is we still have half of it left. The team up on the stage next have come a long way in the last few months, and they've reached their first big quarterfinal in a major. Please welcome LDLC. And they face up against a very, very powerful team. A team who last year were still struggling to find their first win in Counter-Strike Global Offensive. But they have history. Former WCG World Champions, ESWC Champions, and Intel Extreme Masters Champions. And now, the winners and current holders of the ESL One Trophy, virtus.pro! Okay, with the team settled in, let's find out the thoughts of our wonderful guys at the analysis desk, led as always by Sir Scoots.
Thank you, Paul, as always. And again, this time I'm joined by a champion and a legend in his own right. Interesting side story. Heaton, obviously, if those of you don't know who he is. I did my first on-camera interviews back in, we'll just say, CPL 2000s. Yep. And I interviewed you guys in SK. It was amazing stuff. So glad to see that we're both around. You've obviously come from a champion player to now running a very successful championship business in Ninjas in Pajamas. Yep. So welcome to the desk.
Thank you.
So let's get right into this one. Obviously, we've got a storied set of veterans in their own right with three out of the five guys from virtus.pro. And again, these young upstarts, these French guys and the Swiss guy and Maniac, kind of coming out of nowhere, kind of under the radar in the sense of being able to be scouted even by some of these teams. Initial thoughts about the two teams. We'll start with you, Heath.
Well, actually, I think considering the French have been playing so good, especially the really talented individual players, I think they got to meet their overman at the moment. virtus.pro always coming up, just like Paul said, DSWC winner, WCG winner, EMS trophy holders. They always, for some reason, step up one or two levels when they're playing in these big tournaments, and they really want to go to the finals here. So I think no matter how good LDLC actually played, it's going to be, they're up for a challenge here.
I mean, just my thoughts about LDLC. I think, first of all, they're amazing guys. I mean, really, they've worked so hard to get to where they are. And to be in the quarterfinals of a major for them is a huge achievement in itself. But they are not just making up the numbers here. They've got very good players. Apex used to play for Very Games. He was meant to be the young, bright thing that was going to help propel them to the next level. Didn't quite work out. Maniac is one of the best guys just in the world. He's just a beautiful human being. He's great on camera, really good clutch player, great motivator for his team, so passionate about the game. I remember interviewing him at one DreamHack, and he was recalling a clutch that he made. He made like a 1v5 clutch, and he was almost in tears on the interview. Like, he's just so adrenaline pumped up. So these guys really want to win, really want to show. And when I was talking to MBK, he said he thinks that they can. They can upset. Me, on the other hand, I don't. I'll never bet against virtus.pro after what I saw at Gfinity, because they were done and dusted on the first day, and I didn't even know if they were going to get through the groups. Won the whole tournament, one of the greatest ever comebacks in CSGO history in the final. Betting against them right now is stupid.
Yeah, and again, you know, they're number two in the last rankings, and again, we've talked about those rankings are going to shift because Gfinity, some online events, and this event. And then, but even LDLC is ranked five. So, again, maybe a little underdog, but again, in the world rankings, they're right up there with them. Yeah. I'm going to talk about maps, and then I'm going to let you go into some detail. Because kind of the interesting about this matchup is LDLC played Nuke and Inferno so far, kind of more of our standard traditional maps, and virtus.pro quite the opposite. Two overpasses, a win and a loss, and a cash win. So if any of these new maps come into play, especially overpass, virtus.pro has already figured out what works for them and absolutely what doesn't work for them. So it'll be interesting to see when we actually see the maps. But give me some history on some of these maps too.
Okay, well, you can see we're just looking at them there as well. Cache is a great map for them. They played it a bunch of times. I think in the last five times, they've lost once on cache. It's a map they consider to be very adept at it. And I'm not just talking about they've just won it. They've absolutely blown teams away on it. Used 16 twos, which we saw against iBuyPower the other day. That's not a freak result. They did a 16-4 against London Conspiracy at Gfinity. You know, they love that map. It just plays to all of their strengths in the team. So I think if they get the opportunity, they're going to want to play cache, absolutely. I think Overpass, they were one of the teams that were a bit more accepting of the new maps being here. And I guess when you played for as long as they have, you probably crave a bit of variety. I don't know about you.
They actually have been practicing a lot of Overpass as well. And
for the comeback.
They're looking pretty solid on it, considering in scrims at least. And I mean, obviously they want to play Mirage as well, one of the best Mirage team out there. And Cash, just like you said, I mean, if any of those two maps are going to be played, I think they're going to win them both.
Yeah, I mean, that Mirage as well, as Emil rightly says, is one of their strongest maps. They always look to do it. They had a bit of a wobble at Gfinity, where what they did was they should have beat Titan on it, and they had that draw because of that ridiculous Kenny S clutch right at the end, the 1v3, which shouldn't have happened. I know, ridiculous moment of magic. But they're very comfortable on Mirage as well. I mean, they've lost once, I think, in the last five again. They're the maps that they're going to look to try and take into this. When we get into Nuke, other maps of that, and we're going to the Veto now.
Oh, great, perfect.
These are the maps that are really going to be the problem for them. If Virtus get their own way here, this could be another 2-0 blowout.
All right, so Dust 2 right. by LDLC.
And that's no surprise that LDLC have picked that map as well. You know, it's a good map to settle the nerves on. So yeah, you can see CT for Virtus.pro on that map, so Dust 2 is locked in.
And then we've gotten rid of Cobblestone. I see that up top. That's good to see.
There you go. Virtus.pro have picked Mirage.
Mirage.
And LDLC will be starting CT on Mirage. I don't think that'll make much difference.
It looks like it's Nuke.
What's the decider?
Looks like it's Nuke.
Nuke.
Yeah.
And Virtus.pro CT on Nuke for the decider.
Even though I think this is really good map for LDLC, pretty much, because Virtus.pro is such a tactical team. If you see them playing Mirage, you're going to see it now, how they work as a team with the flashbangs, with the nades, and going forward all at the same time, you know, creating confusion when they're playing as terrorists. So the CTs, they're blind, they're flashed, they're smoked off, and then somebody jumps into them. They're playing really solidly, and I think they can adapt to the new maps better than LDLC. So I think those maps for LDLC, really good.
I got to say as well, though, I mean, this is a great way for them to settle. I don't think Virtus.pro play a lot of Dust 2. You know, again, I've analyzed the last 16 maps of every team here. There isn't a Dust 2 game in there. You know, Virtus.pro have kind of not played a lot of Dust 2, and maybe that'll catch them a little bit cold. Nathan NBK was saying that LDLC have this very aggressive play style, no fear. They're going to get in their faces. And I know firsthand LDLC are a confidence team. But then again, we call Virtus.pro Virtus.plow.
Also very aggressive, right?
Exactly.
So this will be interesting.
Exactly. If they get ahead of steam, they're going to run over LDLC and it's 2-0. So just two for me here is the key. If LDLC win this, maybe. Maybe there's the slightest chance. But if they lose Dust2, I don't see how they can win.
Yeah, I mean, that's true. I think Dust2 is going to be an all-open game, to be honest. Mirage is going to go in favor of Virtus.pro unless something magical happens.
Yeah.
Third map, Nuke, can actually be pretty open as well. I mean, it's obviously, Virtus.pro are the favorites, but it's not as... The map's not too good for Virtus, in my opinion.
Yeah. So, players to watch.
Players to watch for me, I've got to say, hugely impressed with Bialy at Gfinity. Him and Snacks both had some incredible moments, the new guys. But I'm going to highlight Bialy just as a player to watch there for Virtus.pro. I think for a young guy, he's really settled into the team. I don't know if you've had a lot of...
Yeah, I really agree. You see, that's the mixture of Virtus.pro at the moment that makes them so good. Yeah, so you have Spikes and Bialy, who's so talented. I mean, you see the rounds they put up. It's just amazing shots. And then you have the Taz, Neo, Pasha, the guys who's like been here forever and bringing the experience to the team, letting the young guys shine. And I mean, it's just a really good mix. And when they're on fire, especially Bialy, in my opinion, they're really, really strong.
All right.
And well, just for LDLC, Uzi. I'm going to say Uzi. I think he's a consummate rifler, very cool under pressure, is capable of clutching. If he comes up big on this map especially, does too, one of his specialities, it'll give LC a chance. It's going to be close, this map. Still fancy Virtus Pro to do a 2-0.
All right, there you have it, folks. Thanks for the feedback, gentlemen. Third quarterfinal starting up. Rotating some new casters in. Ladies and gentlemen, let me give you Pansy and our friend from down under, Top Gun.
Thank you so much, Sir Scoots, and I am joined by the phenomenal Top Gun. We had to steal you away from the analysis desk. You were that well needed. How you doing, buddy?
Good, thank you very much. It's a tough battle. Glad to say you won that battle.
Just
and
about.
Here I am, here I sit. Good to be here with you.
Yeah, we are super excited for this one, and obviously, big game coming up for both of these teams. Virtus Pro reigning champions, not much to say about that.
Absolutely.
But LDLC,
absolutely.
A little bit of an upcomer, a little bit of a surprise, I think, maybe to some. But to your opinion, how do you think they're going to fare in this? We've heard from the analysis desk that they're feeling that if this goes well for Virtus Pro at the start, it's going to carry on throughout the kind of possible three maps, probably two.
Well, look,
do you agree?
I'm a player. I'm not a caster.
Tell me how it is.
Let's get this out there. At this point of the game, at this point of the competition, anyone can win. LDLC, I'm sure they feel like they could take this one out. Virtus Pro are the favorites, I feel.
Okay.
But, you know, being the favorites is just not good enough, is it? It's just not good enough. Look at Spain in the World Cup. They got knocked out. Favorites didn't make it out of groups. And here we are, LDLC, France and Poland. Great game ahead of us.
Very
I can't
true.
Wait.
It's a little bit of a tough one to call because actually I was speaking to a couple of teams prior to the event kicking off, how they felt the others were preparing for this, how the teams were forming into the kind of beast they've now become. And a lot of teams were actually keeping their eyes on LDLC, mostly due to the fact they kind of skipped out on G3. They wanted to get this practice in. They wanted to work their way through. They didn't have the pressure of, you know, going to events, coming back, the travel, the cost of that on a team itself. And I'm sure you know the cost of obviously the traveling and how much I can take it out of you as a team. But LDLC kept the cards close to the desk and to the heart, and they kind of look pretty good coming into this. They've been doing a lot of homework. What are your thoughts on them as a team here?
Absolutely. I mean, look, I've played LDLC. They're a strong team. I mean, there's a reason why they're here today. And, you know, individually, they've got some great players.
Oh, yeah.
Great game changers. And that's what's needed at this point. They need those players to step up and, just provide. Provide for the team. Provide for one another. And like as you said, you know, maybe they've gone under the radar recently.
A little bit.
So, you know, element of surprise, maybe Virtus Pro are the ones, you know, favourites. And when that's the case, you know, the pressure's on them. It's for them to lose. LDLC are coming in as underdogs. I'm sure they're happy with that. I'm sure they agree with that. But, you know, that doesn't mean it's what we love about the game. You know, it's what we love about the game. Anyone can win at this point. Look at that beautiful stage. Fantastic stuff. I can't wait for this game, honestly.
I think we're both in the same mentality. So ladies and gents, let's get ready for that first map. It is Dust 2, obviously on the T side, it will be LDLC. Virtus Pro style on the CT side. Your prediction on this map, who's gonna take it right here?
As I said, Virtus Pro are the favorites. You know, LDLC picked Dust 2. They, best way to get the nerves out of the way, as they said in the analysis room. And they start T side, they can, you know, we'll see what they work towards here. And, stuff and taking it calm, you know, like I said, just getting the nerves out of the way, getting a feel for the opponents, and that's what's needed. It's a best of three. They're not going to win or lose the competition here.
Well, it looks like they are going to be making their move. LDLC starting that push through the double doors, and Apex cracks it open with a lovely little double, and the pressure towards B will begin. Taz sits in, gets taken down, and can you believe it? LDLC, every man still alive, fairly weak, let's bear in mind, but the bomb is planted. This is the perfect start.
Just the start they wanted. Just the start they needed. You know, now they're feeling good. They're feeling confident. They've pretty much got this one in the bag. Something magical from Bialy to bring this one in. The frag will be good for Virtus Pro though, just to get that mental. Then they don't get it. So a 5-for-all exchange in the first round for LDLC. Good start for them.
Big play from Apex there, picking up the triple to actually open this one up. And as you said, this is so important for LDLC. They're a team, as well as Virtus Pro, let's be honest here, that depends on that confidence to get building, to get it going early. And these, not young players, they are still veterans at this LDLC, but
absolutely,
maybe young to this sort of pressure now into CSGO, let's say, to get that first round against Virtus Pro, the reigning champions, that's got to feel good. That has got to get a little bit of those nerves put to bed.
That's what they wanted. That's the start they needed. Now, you know, we've seen what's happened in the past with these ecos. You know, they can easily throw it away here, but I'm sure they're well aware of what's been happening. I'm sure they'll take this one nice and easy. Keep a feel for it. Don't get pressure. Looks like we're in a bit of a pause here.
Yeah. thing there, maybe just a keyboard issue. But that should be fixed nice and quickly. But now let's spin this one around. Let's look at it from VODS Pro. You don't pick up the first pistol. Where does your mind go there? Is it just, okay, next round, wipe it clean?
That's exactly right. These guys are professional. They're seasoned professionals. They've done this, you know, many times before. They know. Counter-Strike is a game of rounds. It's the beauty of it. Each and every round is up for grabs. There's five kills. Five kills that will give you the round and or a bomb plant. So, you know, they know. They're professionals. They're probably not out to win the round. They're probably out to just, you know, take some guns off them, you know, bring their money down for the future rounds. And, you know, we'll see what they can do, so...
Okay.
You know, I'm sure they're not nervous, they're not upset. I'm sure they're still feeling good and confident, as are LDLC, and so they should be with a fantastic start.
Okay, so let's start looking towards what the CT side might be going for now into this sort of second round. Obviously, losing out on the first, you're going to see a couple of CZs, to say the least. Yeah. They are currently in favour. A bit of an understatement to say the minimal of that one, but what sort of impact can they make? What is the best way to play this through if you now know that the team up against you, at minimum, or maximum, should I say, will have at least rifles, or maybe, you know, something a little different, but generally around that mark, it was a very clean round from the T side. Now you're VODS Pro, what do you do to counter that? Is there something you're going for here? Taz, getting a little bit of head armor on, Pasha as well, looking like he's got something building.
Yep.
What sort of play are we
looking at? Look at their boys. They want to win this round. I mean, they're looking for mistakes from LDLC. They're looking for that excitement, if you will. Not that they're inexperienced, but as opposed to them, VODS Pro are out to capitalize on any mistakes that are made. And if LDLC don't make any, they should be able to take this round out. Otherwise...
Let's find out if mistakes are going to be made. Pasha does go first. Happy going to pick him up quite kindly. They're happy with the second and the third. Snacks goes down. Very well played.
Yep.
And that is a team that people thought might be nervous, looking very calm.
No. And that's exactly what they need. It's exactly what they need for the second round. On the anti-ecos, they need their guy that are watching those extremities to make those frags, to not allow them to get into the round. That's exactly what they've done.
Perfect. Late Taz does find Apex, gets himself the AK smoke. Not follow, bomb planted, however, so you can imagine this will go the way we expect. Taz is down to 11 HP, so minimal to say the least, but I can imagine LDLC might consider having a little peek, and Maniac will find Taz. And this is two very clean rounds. I think they've only lost Apex so far, and a vast amount of bomb plants. They are playing absolutely on point here.
Yeah, absolutely. This is exactly the start they wanted. If they can keep this momentum going and hopefully take out this one, and at this point, they're not out to win the game right now. They need to get this round without any deaths. From a terrorist point of view, from where they are right now, they don't want to lose any players. They've got them on the back foot. And if they can keep the numbers up all throughout the whole round, they will get into the VODS Pro minds, if you will.
Well, let's see what we've got going down here. It does seem as a little bit of a split taking the time. As you said, a lot of pressure and weight on this round. LDLC want to play it as cleanly as possible. However, VODS Pro trying to get a little cheeky stack there. Taz does get taken down, but Apex pushing in again, a key player so far for LDLC. Pierce through, but it's Maniac to find Neo, and it looks clinical so far, and it might be staying that way. Uzi finds one, finds a second, and the third would be picked up with the nade from Happy. So again, perfectly played out. This is clinical.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We talk about how easy it is to lose these anti-ecos nowadays. Not only do they win those anti-ecos, they've only lost two players in the first three rounds. That's the start they needed. Let's see what they can take from there.
Let's start looking from VODS Pro's point of view here. LDLC, phenomenal start. Perfect near on. First gun round coming in. What is the mentality of VODS Pro here? If you were in their shoes, clean slate, or do you start getting a little worried?
No. VODS Pro, it's still early in the game. I mean, wow. What a shot from Apex. No, as I was saying, they want to stick to the game plan. They want to do what they spoke about already. I'm sure they're not down and out, even with that first frag.
Well, let's get back to that, because right now Pasha was waiting to receive, but the A push did begin then. And right now we are sitting at a 4v3 situation in favor to LDLC. Bialy put himself in the side, but LDLC don't seem rushed. They're still happy to take their time, it seems.
No, great revenge, a revenge like that. Now they're taking their time. It's exactly what they should be doing.
Well, let's see where they take this. Time is of the essence. Still a lot to work with. 1 minute and 3 seconds. No need to panic here for the T side. They're building themselves up. Bialy is still on A. Taz sitting around in mid. Happy might actually go for a peek. He's going to spot out one. That's Taz down. That is going to open things up. But Neo, waiting in the wings, does get the tag back. So at the moment, good exchanges in favor of the T side. And it looks like that B push is about to begin. So Neo does get smashed down by Kelly. But Bialy, nothing to do here. And this is once again LDLC looking very clinical, and they've nearly looked like it was back in those pistols where it was very one-sided.
Now look, a fantastic entry from Apex early in that round. Put VODS Pro on the back foot there, and they got a frag back, but with a perfect revenge, it allowed them to do what they want mid-game. And mid round. And here we see a dominant round for LDLC.
So, big round coming in for LDLC. Bomb will be going off any second now, and they will continue the hunt. I think they know that that will. Will probably be in the hands of Bialy by now, and he's going to tuck himself away and try and pretty much stick alive and stay alive and see if maybe he can catch one on the way out, but mostly see if he can keep that AWP. In possession, he does.
Wow.
What? How did no one find him? Finally, Kelly takes him down. But not exactly the way you'd want to go around that one.
That's very bad for Virtus Pro because, you know, the situation that they are and what just happened, you know. But. Look, that's a big kill for LDLC. I know they had that round in the bag, but they've taken that AWP off them. First gun round. Good work by LDLC.
Well, let's find out. Going to round number five, LDLC currently 4-0 up. Overall surprised to see the T's winning these pistols these days, but to convert the first gun round for LDLC, that has got to be doing wonders for them. And let's find out if they can get any more. Obviously, CT side of Virtus Pro are down to these CZs. Nothing too great, a couple of P250s in the mix, but all in all, still very dangerous, as we've seen so far in this tournament, the CZs. You can't really underestimate them, but I think LDLC are playing the pace perfectly. They're building up Bialy. Might go for a little bit of a peek here. He could catch a couple off guard, but LDLC seem aware, seem ready, and look like they're going to find it. There we go. So Apex does find Bialy. He is down. And it's just so smooth for LDLC. They look like they've got this planned to the absolute letter.
Yeah, they look well prepared for this. It all comes down to entries at the moment so far. It's what's been working against Virtus Pro are the entry frags.
Smack's not going to get anything, sadly. And there we go. Finally, Pasha does get himself in this game, taking down Mania. But immediate revenge kills coming in every time here.
And that's what's needed. At this level of the game, it's all about the revenge kills. That's what took him out the first gun round. And look, now they're capitalizing. They're feeling good. You have a look at them. You can see they're confident. They're not getting carried away. They're not going to make any mistakes. And that's probably what they're telling one another. That's what they're thinking inside their heads. Let's not get carried away. This isn't over yet. And that's the mentality needed at this level, at this stage, against these opponents. It's not over yet.
Well, we are going to be seeing Passionel picking up that AWP. Big round coming in for Virtus Pro. They definitely want this one on the board. Otherwise, there might be that small little bit of worry building. Just let's see how it goes down. Obviously, a lot of time to work with here. No rush for these guys. Pasha looking for the opener with that AWP in hand. Boosted up, actually, so interesting to see how this one plays out. He does catch a glimpse of one. Not going to land too much, however. And once again, LDLC seem near on unfazed by this.
Absolutely. LDLC doing well. Virtus Pro are on the back foot right now. I'm sure the situation that they've put in, especially losing that AWP and the way he lost it, that sort of stuff plays into your mind. You see a teammate lose a gun like that when he was trying to save it. They're not trying to win the round, but these are the little objectives that they need when they are losing rounds. So, you know, perfect time for LDLC to capitalize on what looks a little bit nervy, a little bit shaken up Virtus Pro.
But this could be dangerous. Snax is waiting, and there's Bialy coming in, finding Apex, finally doing damage to the Frenchman as the second repeat comes out, and finally everything falls into place.
That's it.
But leaving Happy, the last man alive in a 1v4. Surely not going to get anything out of this, but that was what they needed, Virtus Pro. What was the difference there?
Exactly.
How did that finally come into play?
Ultimately, it came down to making their shots. Initially, LDLC were making the entries and, you know, revenging well, as opposed to this time, Virtus Pro made the entries, and then they revenge well, which opens up the round for them. So a good round for them to get those nerves off their shoulders, if you will.
Yeah, you definitely start wanting that first round. Once you see that scoreline building and building and building, it seems like it's a bigger hurdle every single time.
But these guys are professionals. They've been in these situations many times before.
Still very early games, obviously very early in the rounds as well. Obviously only 7 rounds in so far. 5-1, however, is the scoreline. Surprisingly in favor to LDLC so far, and that is a perfect beginning for them. AWP play takes down Bialy. Pasha trying to find an answer to this, but there's no avenging kills for Virtus Pro at this point.
Absolutely. I'd love to see what happens for the rest of this round, because just after losing that their first round, they come up with a big entry frag. You know, 15 seconds into the round, that's exactly what they wanted LDLC, exactly what VP didn't. And see what they can conjure up here with a man advantage.
It looks like the attention is being brought at least towards A. There's Pasha waiting on that site. Probably one of the men you don't want to really run into at this moment. But still, let's see how LDLC find this execution. They have still around a minute to go here, but Pasha goes for the peak, gets it on the second try, and that's avenging at least his fallen teammate earlier on, bringing it back down to that 4v4. And Snacks once again in a possibly huge situation. Smoke around him. Pasha's found another, and here comes Snacks with the double. taking down LDLC and leaving just Apex alive, and he will be dealt with by Pasha, and that's a big round for VODS.pro.
Absolutely, they were a man down early on. They regrouped, they didn't panic, if you will. LDLC perhaps could have played that a bit better, that maybe they were trying to force some rotators around because of that early frag, but they followed through with the same bomb site. Perhaps a great frag from Pasha early on, and great positioning for Snacks, getting a double there, making it look easy.
Yeah, and I've got to say, when VODS.pro seemed to get that control through short, both rounds seem to be coming off the back of that sort of aspect. Do you think that might force a bit of an adaption from LDLC, or are they just still working their way into this? It's still early at this moment.
I think the way they've been playing the first few rounds, I'm sure they're confident. They're happy to have him there. They want to take him on. They're confident. You know, they'll headshot them first, unfortunately. Not this time for Apex, though.
Yeah, and we know the danger of VODS.pro once that confidence is there beside them. Once those rounds come in, those kills, they seem to follow back to back to back. And right now, Neo has found Uzi. That is a perfect play towards mid, utilizing this one well and just understanding.
That's very confident play. Very confident play from Neo to creep through a smoke like that, to spot those mid doors, getting the frag, getting what his team needed. Now they're in a 5v2 situation. I'm sure they're feeling pretty good at this one.
Now, if you're in LDLC shoes right here, right now, where'd you take yourself? Is it time to get running?
There's 45 seconds left in the round. They're doing exactly what they need to do. They went for frags in separate parts of the map. Unfortunately, one couldn't get it, the other did. You know, in a 2v5 situation with so much time left, I'm sure great players like these, they'll never give up. They'll go to the end. You know, they just need to make those frags, even when they're down and out, and bring it back to a 2v3, if you will. And then, you know, do something from there. This situation, VODS.pro too strong, holding the ground and getting another round.
Yeah, 3-5 is that current scoreline. Your reigning champions, VODS.pro, are building themselves into this one. LDLC's plans slowly being held in place by Pasha there. Opening
fantastic
up
shot
again. That confidence must be right beside him. The second won't follow so easily.
Absolutely. This is not what LDLC want.
Right, definitely not. They're being questioned on every single turn, and Apex feeling confident gets stopped. Pasha finding form early on here, and now three possible victims stand. He's gonna find another. Pasha with the triple, just taking LDLC out one by one by one and making it look so easy.
Absolutely, this is what legends are made of. An easy three down. They're in a 5v2 situation now. Pasha's done his job. You'll see now, he'll probably take it easy. He'll take it calm. Professionals, they won't get too frag hungry. He'll rotate, and there he is. Capitalized.
God.
That's a four down. That's well played. Absolutely well played by Pasha. Now he wants it, and
he
gets
it. That's the five. Pasha, ladies and gents.
Well done.
Wow, what a stunning round.
That's what it is.
And you've got to give credit to that man. He searched those frags out. He found everyone in not exactly an easy place either.
That's experience. That's class. That's making your shots. He got three frags in one spot. He rotated. He said, you know what? I don't need any more right now. I'll let my team step in. He went. He rotated. They rotated with him, and then they went to him. Beautiful. Well played, Pasha. Well deserved those. Fantastic stuff.
And in the mentality of LDLC here, if you were in their shoes, now pushed back down after such a... Oh, my word, Pasha finds another. It's against an eco, but the CZs, they do cause some pain. But it looks like VODS.pro are finding their footing here. But back to the point, LDLC now had such confidence at the start. How do you get yourselves back into this? How do you get that confidence back when Pasha is doing this to you?
These are the questions. These are the life questions. Lauren, listen, what the problem with that first round, that ace round was, he TD'd, they got a team down, and then they resorted to an eco. That forced them into the eco. So they know they needed to win that round to not eco. So not only did they lose that round, they got teamed down. So now the confidence, the juggernaut has started over here with the VODS prototype. Yeah. Pasha, he's into it. He's hungry. He's feeling good.
Let's see if finally LDLC can maybe chip away at what is building the storm behind VODS.pro right now. 5-5. Still early games. This is a best of three. I keep getting the mentality of a best of one, but we have possibly three maps here. But this man on your screen keeps going. He'll be over in two, and he's looking. And he's not going to find it. Happy will stop it this time. Not going to get a second, though. Avenging kills this time, seemingly in the pockets of VODS.
That's it. That's what VODS.pro need. That's fine. I mean, Pasha's down, but a one-for-one exchange. That's what they need. That's what LDLC needs. That's a good exchange from LDLC, just as much as it is for VODS.pro. Happy making a great frag on Pasha. Slowing down that juggernaut. Now, see what they do here. We see the CTs rotating around. This is the difference between a good team and a great team. You see the movement here. see the movement. You see how they've each got, they're almost in a line. They've got each other's backs, and they know that. And they're going to wait for LDLC to make a move here, and we'll see how they react.
Looks like they predicted right over on the virtus.pro camp. They know where they're building towards, but Maniac has found Taz. He only has to spring into action, but Uzi breaking through. They're building up here, LDLC. The A site looking vulnerable, and the execution then was on point.
Absolutely. And again, it came down to the Revengers. The entry followed through with the Revenger. Didn't allow virtus.pro to string kills together. And great work here from LDLC. And again, it comes down to that first frag. Comes down to that first kill. Pasha, yeah, you can't criticize him. He wasn't overly hungry, though. He went for the open the round for his team. Happy making a fantastic shot, which led to this round for LDLC.
Right, so 5-6, LDLC get themselves finally another round in. Will they build any more? Let's find out. Obviously, as you said, the opening kills being so vital. Snacks, that was a great look at Snacks' position right now. He is going to be right amongst them. Apex first on. Oh, Apex stops him in his tracks. That is big, but Neo found Kelly as well. So a one-for-one trade, nothing lost, really nothing gained. But take me through that confidence from Snacks. They're going into those lower B tunnels.
Yeah,
is that the confidence getting
that, in? That is exactly what that is. That is knowing your opponents. That is knowing your own personal capability. And regardless of the scoreline, a team like virtus.pro, they will always play this way.
Well, Bialy in another bit of a position, a possibility to take this further. LDLC looking to switch up a little though. Flashes, smokes through, Miz, Apex moves in, finds Taz. Pasha stops him, but still very close, even trades. No full commitments yet from LDLC. And at the moment, if they do head the way they are, it could go very badly wrong. Three players waiting, watching. Pasha, Bialy, and Neo by B. 45 seconds. Where are LDLC going to take this? It looks like they are tying away. I'm waiting to see the full commitment. Don't want to give away too much in case.
That's very well done there by LDLC.
This is nice.
These little things.
They forced it. They forced one player away, but Neo still waits. Happy finds him. That is perfect. And now Pasha lines them up. Not going to find such an easy kill this time. As now the three players from LDLC continue to work forward. Maniac's nade will connect. And Bialy left in a 1v3. Bomb yet to go down. Uzi does get it going. So now, Bialy playing up the options. Not much to the arsenal. No smokes, no flashes, no mollies this time. And a smoke by those doors. Time is going to be of the essence here. Uzi to the right, two to the left. And it is going to be go time. Bialy gets one. Looks for the second. He gets the second, not the third. Uzi
great
held
effort.
His nerve.
Great
but
effort.
Bialy got close.
Absolutely. Look, that was a very well played round by LDLC. They ended up in a 3v3 situation. They knew that virtus.pro knew where they were going. So they slowed it down. They threw a couple of smokes, threw a couple of flashes, made them rotate out of B, and then capitalized on that. That's great teamwork there from LDLC. That's earned them that round.
Considering the pressure situation that they did that in, it's phenomenal to be able to do that, to be able to drag your team, to lead them in the opposition from one side to the other. We did see Happy going for the opener there. Not get it on the first time advancing, second time catches, I think, Snacks then in the heels.
That is a big shot, absolutely.
So, now, LDLC, first time we've really seen them working towards B there. They did obviously toy with mid a little bit, but at the moment, they seem to be once again happy to slow down the pace here.
And so they should. And so they should. They're in a great position here, LDLC. They're in a fantastic position. They're playing well, they know they are. virtus.pro, the few rounds they've won has come to individual brilliance, which is, you know, at this level, that's fine. But right now, LDLC are playing much better. Still early in the game, it's easy to say they are terrorist side on Dust 2. Yep. It's easy for them to have that sort of cohesion and for it to show.
Well, let's find out if that confidence continues with Bialy standing in the way. Not
another
for long.
Another great revenge.
So on point with this, but Pasha, as you said, the individual brilliance is there, but it's back and forth consistently. Every kill they get, there is one answering, leaving it still even in a 3v3. The 8 execution is beginning. Maniac's found Taz. Uzi hunts with him, and Uzi will find Snacks, leaving just Neo alive. And time again, as you mentioned, these avenging back and forth kills are huge, but the bomb did not make it across there. Neo keeping hope alive, but it gets put to bed by Maniac, and another round on the board for Team LDLC.
That's just great shooting. That's just great shooting. I think it was Bialy that got that first entry frag that wasn't allowed to capitalize for a double or even a triple. That's great work from LDLC. That's sharpshooting. These are the revenges they need, especially on terror side. That's what they need. If they keep going one-for-one exchanges, they'll open up the map, they'll get into the bomb sites, they'll get that bomb down. They'll make it very hard for the CT sites here.
Well, CT side now down to a scout, a couple of CZs. Nothing great in the arsenal, but we've seen damage done. I don't want to start underestimating those CZs. No, they have been such a heavy hitter throughout this tournament, but at the moment, not really going to find that just yet. But the Alien Snacks are still happy to get quite aggressive here towards short. I'm not sure if Maniac caught a glimpse then, but the Alien will back away. And with 1 minute left, Pasha has found one. Snacks gets two. Don't tell me this will turn around. I'm getting a little nervous here for LDLC because Neo's found Maniac. They're doing this one with just those CZ pistols. They got themselves two AKs and still got that scout in effect. So now Happy and Uzi, they're in trouble. And LDLC, you can never take this lightly. Even Taz working round, he knows there's going to be one close, and he's going to find it. Stunner of a shot towards Uzi, and fantastic. They've turned this right on its head. Just
like that, a 1v4. Fantastic work here from VODS.pro. And again, it's Pasha. He's stepping up here for VODS.pro. He's making these entries. He's making these frags. He's keeping his team alive.
And Happy does at least get Bialy now. Bomb is by T-Spawn. I'm pretty sure Taz knows that too. Happy going to have to work for this. 32 seconds left. Not the situation I can imagine they thought this would be, but to underestimate the individual talent, as you highlighted, of VODS.pro, even with just those CZs, is a mistake. Neo will finish. Happy goes down, and we will be seeing VODS.pro turning around. Not just an eco with
that
scout in play.
That hurts. Oh, yeah. When you're LDLC, that hurts. That really does. That could have been 9-5 towards
that's a beautiful scoreline.
LDLC. VODS.pro happy about that one in final round of the half. We'll see. What they can do here for this. LDLC should keep their heads up, though. They've played an absolutely fantastic first half against LDLC. VODS.pro, sorry.
Now, let's look at this situation. Because it's turn 1A. We've got a double AWP running with VODS.pro against a Galil couple of pistols with LDLC. And let's see if it is going to be the scoreline of maybe 9-6 or the more likely 7-8. So, smoke's being put down. LDLC building themselves up again. Nothing really gained just yet, but we're seeing that mid play come through. Taz will be the first on the line, but Neo's found one. Taz gets the second. Oh, but Neo decides to make it harder for himself. So why not? Let's take down Taz and get more kills for Pasha as he does find Uzi, leaving just Maniac alive in a 1v. Neo will find and secure another round of the board for VODS.pro, a well-needed one at the surprising scoreline half.
Absolutely. I think both teams will be happy with this scoreline. I think LDLC should be the happier, although the problem with this is you talk about momentum, you talk about what's needed, that losing that eco that could have given them that round and could have forced a better scoreline, if you will, for LDLC. That hurts. That hurts going into the other half. If that happened earlier in the game, you know, they would have gotten over it by now. Hopefully LDLC can recover, not let it get to them. Otherwise, look, great position for both LDLC. I'm sure VODS.pro are feeling good about themselves. I'm sure they're feeling confident. They know they can take this one out, and I feel the same way too. Look, VODS.pro are a top class side, and you know, it'd be great to see how they recover from what's just happened.
Definitely going to be a question, and I want to take into account now the fact that VODS.pro will be on the T side coming into this, a side that can give you comebacks. You can build, you can grow, you can start steamrolling, adding that pressure on. Is this a side you feel they'll do well? Is this a side that they've got comfort on, do you think, or do you think they're going to be maybe struggling against LDLC? Because we've heard they have similar styles occasionally, both quite aggressive, both depending on that individual talent every now and then. Who's got the better side now for their team style, maybe?
It couldn't be any more even. I mean, for me personally, Dust 2, it's an even side. There's no, you know, CT isn't, you know, harder or easier than Terrorist side. So for LDLC and VODS.pro here, it comes down to making those revenges, making those frags, getting those entries, getting their foot in the door, and they're capitalizing on that. We saw LDLC do a fantastic job in the first half, so hopefully they can keep that going. Just for the underdogs here. Look, I'm an underdog. I represent Australia. We're yet to win a game, so you know I am cheering on the underdogs here. So I want to see LDLC keep up this good form, keep up that teamwork, and you know, stay confident and take it to take it to VODS.pro, the champions, if you will.
Yeah, and Dust 2 was LDLC's pick. Polaris there in the crowd. And I've got to say, the audience here has been fantastic so far. And I'm hoping that we see another brilliant half as we are now live into the second half here of the first map in this best of three final stages. VODS.pro up against LDLC. LDLC now on the CT side. T side will be VODS.pro. And here we go. They're not wasting any time. Bialy opens up towards Apex, and now Maniac's around. He gets a good bit of damage, but zero kills to boot. And now Uzi trying to do a little bit of work. Kelly round the backside does find Bialy, but that bomb is now down and planted. Four T players in this B site. LDLC gonna have to work on this retake. Can they do it? Snacks already finds Happy. Taz finds Kelly, and Taz will close room towards Uzi. And I've got to say it, they made that look far too simple.
That's exactly what I was talking about earlier. That's the momentum that they wanted to take. You know, they won that echo. They won those last two rounds. They stringed them together, and they took it straight into that first round of the second half. They rushed them. They said, look, here we are. We're coming for you. You're not going to stop us. You know, great entries, great work. Now they're getting the nerves out of the way. They're doing exactly, they want to do exactly to LDLC what they did to them. So a good, a strong first round for VODS.pro to bring it even.
See what they have planned this time around. We've known the danger of the CZs now. I think VODS.pro found out firsthand pretty much what can happen, but the rifle's in play. They're going to be taking this one cautiously to an extent for an aggressive team, I can imagine. And let's see where they build towards. What would you say is the best place to take now this second round in with the threat of possible CZs in play?
Where they go is kind of irrelevant at this point, as long as they go together. And that's what you see them doing. They're partnering up, and that's what they need to do. They need to stick together.
Let's see if they can make this one count. Apex did find one, but Snacks and Taz continue to push through, leaving just Happy and Uzi alive. This should be a clean, nearly clean round, and look at Uzi. Bialy. Well, he get the clean shot. Well, Bialy did take down Happy, so not exactly the
He'll be happy
way
with
up,
that. He'll be happy with that.
He does get the Galil, and I think that's time to back out if he can.
Yep. Slow things down a bit. Hang on to a gun. They're going to be a kill again here. And look, against CZs, against the pistols.
It looks like actually Passion might find him, though. Bomb is ticking. He's caught a glimpse of Uzi. My heart almost breaks for Uzi. That's not the man you want hunting you down, if any. A little bit of damage here and there. Snacks going for the hunt as well. Will he even make it out? No! Passion takes him down. And it's a good round for VODS.pro there. They're pretty much back all even now. They're building. That confidence is there with them. Yep. They're warmed up. 9-8. They've got the slight advantage, but we're still waiting on that first real gun round from LDLC.
Yep. It's still anyone's game at this point. You see VODS.pro doing what LDLC did on those anti-ecos. They stuck together, they took their time, they made their shots, and they stuck, you know, they forced the site together. That's what they need to do.
I think VODS.pro gonna pretty much bulldoze their way down towards A at the moment. Bialy is leading through long. Passion, Taz with him. Those rifles just loving this range, pushing LDLC to their limits, but actually Maynek has taken down Pasha, so we're doing a little bit of damage, and jig is certainly up, but Snacks does find Maniac, and this should continue surely with Neo finding Happy. And this is just comfortable work, it looks like, for VODS.pro, but they are taking a little bit of damage here and there.
Absolutely. LDLC slowing it down, keeping them where they are, not letting them get too confident. That's what they want to do. They might not win this round, but if they make them think twice on the decisions they make, that's what they want to do for these ecos.
They only found Apex, but smoke, there might be a little bit of a surprise waiting. Don't want to give away too much, but I think Snack just caught a little bit of a glimpse of the gun there. And there we go, Bialy will take down Kelly, and that was just a little bit of a pixel showing through the smoke, but to these guys that's a big kind of giveaway. But still, Uzi left 1v3. I think he knows this one's not going to be his, but regardless of that, VODS.pro having a little bit of a shaky start. They've worked out okay on the CT side in the end. Now starting on the T half, is this looking like they're getting better and better round by round, or are we just waiting to see LDLC with slightly better weapons
guns
beside them?
Absolutely, yeah. I think we are. It's still early. The second half has started. They've got the start that LDLC had, and you know, look, it's for me, Dustu, it's such a hard side to say which is better. I don't know if terrorists are better. I don't know if counter-terrorists is easier. It's hard to say. It depends on the play styles. It depends on the teams, and these are similar play styles and teams. So. Now the first gun round on the way here, so we'll see what LDLC want to do with this, and or what VODS.pro. Be interesting to see if they actually rush to keep that momentum going, like they did in the pistol, just to get back in their faces. They're LDLC are now happy to have their guns. Now they want to do something with it. We'll see if VODS.pro doesn't give them the time.
Nothing landing initially, and it's even a double AWP in play. Actually, Snacks goes for the open. We caught a glimpse then on long. I don't know if he actually connected. No, he didn't. I think Maniac will get away pretty much scot-free down towards long, but at the moment, Kelly running with the AWP as well. Galil in the hands of Uzi. Oh, that's a big nade. Kelly down to 37 HP. and there's still a lot of time to play with here. And you said the gravity of this round is absolutely huge. You don't want to start losing this out. This is why LDLC would have wanted Kelly finding Neo straight away. And just the opening pick there. Gonna pay dividend, but Pasha finds one back. Happy goes down one for one. And Pasha's going for more. Pasha with the aggression. It doesn't stop with this man. Completely alone, finally joined by Bialy. And he's got B by himself.
That's exactly right. When you've got a player that can do that.
Unbelievable stuff. And now we're going to see LDLC having to build back in here somehow. I don't think you can. Can you really stop virtus.pro once that confidence is there? And Bialy says no. Bialy says no again. And that is virtus.pro picking up the first gun round here in the second half. Very important round for them all in all. 11-8. And I thought, you know, with that opening kill going to Kelly, then I was like, nah. That's maybe LDLC's little bit of a foot in the door.
Yeah,
look, but then Pasha just shut it.
They gave Pasha an AWP. They said, listen, go see what you can do. They were a man down. It didn't faze him. He did what he wanted to do. He got a couple of entries. He took a bomb site, like you said, by himself. And look, that hurts. But I guess the upside for LDLC, wow.
Is there an upside?
Great shooting. No, look, the upside for LDLC is that, you know, when it comes down to one player just making shots like that, it means there's nothing wrong with the game plan. Stick to the game plan. Don't start getting nervous now. Don't start doubting yourselves.
Well, Apex, no doubt there, did go for the aggression with the CZ flash up and over, but didn't find much more than the barrel of Snax's gun. But Happy, feeling confident, goes for it again with the CZs, and they can occasionally rip through teams. I'm sure Fnatic will tell you that. And there we go, Kelly with the triple. Where the hell did that just come from?
The CZ, welcome.
Yeah, indeed.
Welcome to my screen.
Now 1v2. He's picked up the 3. He'd have to go for the ace here. He's got 8 HP. I don't think that's quite on the cards, but that is the power of the CZ. You can never underestimate this thing. Well, he's going for this one. Snax on site. He's got the drop on him. Oh, no, he doesn't. Taz was watching, and Kelly will fall. But not a bad bit of impact there.
No. That'll hurt their bank system. It won't matter at all if they can't get a round of this second half. Yeah, I'm sure virtus.pro are rich. You can see their money there. They won't be econing anytime soon, absolutely. And look, like I said, LDLC, they just need to keep composed. They need to not get nervous. They need to stick to their game plan.
Well, Pasha tries to hold it again. Not going to land that one. It was Snax who actually got down the player, first of all, the previous time through those double doors. So a little bit of a switch up. It looks like putting a lot of focus towards B here for LDLC, but Snax has found Maniac. And look at Apex getting aggressive through mid. Does get one, but avenge immediately. It's almost like that first half with those constant avenging kills from LDLC. But now in virtus.pro's hands.
Yeah, so those revenges will always benefit the terror side, the aggressor side.
See that it's going to work anymore. Uzi does find Taz. So stop virtus.pro with the easy path through mid. And no one yet willing to find any further pacing here. The T side weighing up their options. virtus.pro still have time. Still have a lot of options available. We saw how much LDLC were able to draw players away from sites with just those smokes and flashes through mid. And I'm curious to see if that's the plan again here, but obviously with virtus.pro now, as we do see that three-man kind of roaming squad weighing up the options, and they have split a good couple of players apart now.
No, they have, and they're sticking together now. And that's what they need to do in these situations. They can isolate a zone, they can outnumber the person in that side, and Happy has to do something special here, otherwise they're going to be in serious trouble here, obviously.
Here we go, Snax! Opens it up.
That's a great entry.
That's just perfect, absolutely perfect. They drew LDLC away from mid. They pushed in towards B. They took down one. Bialy takes down the second. And now only Kelly in the way, but he gets Snax, but the bomb's still planted. And don't really want to be walking into this situation, but Kelly looking for options, you know, waiting to receive, as is Bialy. This looks like it's going to be 13-8, unless Kelly can do something phenomenal. Bomb is ticking every second now. There's no easy shots to be found. Dangerous play from Neo. There goes to the peak. Both players now showing their hand. Can Kelly do anything? I don't think he can. He's going to try it, but back and forth, drawing them left, right, and center. Neo will secure. And that is a brilliant virtus.pro. I love that play from them there.
No, that's great work. They isolated the player. They took the site. They got the entry frag that they needed, and then they didn't get hungry. They didn't get too aggressive. They didn't make any mistakes. They were left in a 2v1 situation. They forced Kelly to, you know, like we said, do something special. And it's just hard to do so against such classy players, such experienced players.
And let's just point out right now, Pasha is on 21-14. That's an astounding scoreline. And indeed,
class.
You cannot stop the virtus plow right now. LDLC certainly trying. Kelly, valiant effort so far. But as you said, it's so hard sometimes to stop that one player, that confidence player. But right now, Apex is in a great spot. VODS Pro are working their way up, sure, but happy finding Bialy. Might cause a little bit of a problem towards this. Apex in a stunner of a position, gets the tag towards one, stops Neo from dropping down. Kelly finds Snacks, and this is going substantially better for LDLC. There's still Taz and Pasha, and if Pasha's alive, I don't want to call it either way just yet. But 1 minute
no,
left. You can't
absolutely
doubt this man.
So in this position, I'm sure VODS Pro are still feeling good. They still feel like they can win this round, and that's the confidence that these great players have, because the fact is they can win this round. They believe they can win this round. And so long as they feel that way, sky's the limit. We'll see what Pasha can do here coming up to long.
Maniac will be waiting. You can see the focus on LDLC's faces right there. It is intense for them, even though they know the round is pretty much numbers-wise in the bag. But look at this. Pasha goes in! Pasha claims
wow.
Maniac. And we said you can't quite write him out just yet. Kelly tries to connect. Not going to find Taz too easily. Pasha pushes up long. Pasha goes out. Not going to expect Apex at the cars. And now Kelly should land the shot. He doesn't. Taz gets free reign, but he won't follow up. And Uzi will close out the round. But as you said, even with those two players alive, it still felt dangerous with Pasha standing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And that's what they do. They, if two players go out for looking for a pick in two separate spots and they get a kill each, all of a sudden, the odds are pretty much in their favor. They've got a bomb site to take. They can take out one more easily. It'll be a 2-on-1. And before you know it, they're back on even ground. So it's hard to write off any teams. It doesn't matter how early in the round it is, how far behind they are. And VODS Pro showed after what was a solid start for LDLC. Now VODS Pro seem to be just looking better. They're feeling good. They're making their shots.
Look at LDLC's positioning right now. Bialy will go for the peak. Kelly opened
that's
up
a
with
great frag.
This is going to be big here for LDLC. VODS Pro still trying to get towards where they initially intended, which was A. But at the moment, Bialy and Snacks were the only two to make it through the gauntlet of fire. Bialy does find Maniac at least on towards A, but the bomb not exactly in the best of spots here. Already happy, waiting, happy, will stop Bialy and Snacks back in the hell up. Does get back in for more, actually. Three players literally waiting for him to appear. I'm not really certain he's going to get much out of that one.
Snacks knows it's a split-second decision. When you're in a 1v3 like that, you've got one chance to make that frag, and if you don't, you reposition. That's exactly what he's doing now. Again. Although it's a 3v1, he's trying to catch him 1v1, and that's exactly what it needs to do. So long as he isolates the counter-terrorists, doesn't allow them to revenge for one another, he's still in a good position. Which is odd to say in a 1v3.
Yeah, normally it's crossfires till dawn, but we're not seeing that. LDLC is still happy to roam a little.
Of course. No, LDLC are making the right choices here. They're not playing at him. They're falling behind. They're trying to get him into their crossfire. And
that's what they did.
Exactly. And that's what there needs to be done in those situations. Because when you're up a few players, it's the round is yours to lose. And that's the problem. And that's what sometimes can happen with the lesser teams. I'm sure these players, they don't make these mistakes. They know these things. They'll back each other up. They won't get frag hungry. They'll sit down. They'll make him do something special. Without anything special, they know they've got that round one.
13-10, current scoreline. LDLC looked a little out of it once, VODS Pro side building, but they have found their footing into the CT side now. Certainly getting a good couple of rounds on the board, and it has forced the T's to get down on the P250s. CZ's not too much beside them, but still, let's see what VODS Pro can do here. Maybe get a couple of kills, maybe cut off mid and then force the B. The smoke's not going through. He's going to put that one up. He's going to at least draw Apex back, but he has very little vision on this. And those two players isolated at B now, one being Happy, peers through. It's going to be Uzi finding one with Happy, and there we go. Good couple of kills back to back, minimizing that threat, but Pasha still dancing around between the bullets. Does get one, but there we go. Dealt with by LDLC, but that was a well-executed round from
well
VODS Pro.
Shot.
But
absolutely. A few of their players were on red HP.
Yeah.
They were one shot away from death. So good work by VODS Pro. They took a gun off him. Though I think in hindsight they'd be quite disappointed. Even though it was just an eco, they probably don't expect to win the round. Of course, that's their goal, though they just want to take guns off them. That's why they spent a few $100 just for a couple of pistols, just to take some guns off them that are obviously worth much more. That's what you aim for on your ecos.
So, current plans right now, though, your VODS Pro, LDLC are starting getting a little bit closer. How do you start playing this one? More confident? Slower?
You slow it down a bit. You wait for your opponent to make a mistake. It's easy to start making mistakes when you start getting ahead of yourself, if you will. That's what they want to see. Now, we'll see what LDLC do here. We'll see if they do get aggressive in certain spots of the map.
like this
exactly
from
like
Kelly.
This.
But as you said, aggression could be something the virtus.pro would look towards to try and manipulate, try and find a way into. But 1 minute left on the board. We will have to see the T side making their move fairly soon. Flash on long. Maniac will reply with a molly of his own, but still slow round. But I think Maniac did catch a glimpse of one there. Not sure if he's aware of how many members of virtus.pro there are about to come flooding into him. Tucks himself into pit. He does have support in the form of Apex finding Pasha. And now here we go. Push does begin. Kelly finds Neo. Maniac still somehow alive. Kelly is supporting perfectly with that AWP. And now, still Taz and Snacks trying to fight a way through. And they both do just that, leaving a 2v2 situation. Snacks' confidence coming through. Bomb does get chucked over towards Snacks. That should be able to go down. I don't think any player really can stop that just yet. Happy is working up long, though. Finds Taz first. Tag comes in. 9 HP left. Molly to try and drop it out. Uzi's found Taz, and oh, it looks like it's almost all over, but can you believe it? Snacks hold on with the double. Happy and Uzi go down.
LDLC will be disappointed with that. They'll be very disappointed with that. That was theirs. They should have won that round. Unfortunate, though. Great play from Snacks.
Kelly with that AWP as well.
Kelly doing a fantastic job, just like Pasha was, especially in that first half. He's making those entries, and what LDLC are doing better than virtus.pro were in that first half, although virtus.pro are in the lead, they're not allowing virtus.pro to get the revenges. They're getting frags, they're getting the kills, they're getting the initials, and then they're getting out of there. They're repositioning, they're not allowing to break even, if you will. And look, they're still looking good, you know. It's hard to say which way this is going to go still, though. Virtus.pro now. Snacks getting taken out by Apex. That's a strong frag. That's what they needed. And he gets that kill, he stays alive, and he's out of there. Now they've got the man advantage. Now it's back onto virtus.pro to, like I said, do something special.
Let's see if they can muster up anything here. The 26th round, 14 to 11. virtus.pro are being pushed by a team that thought, well, many thought would be a little bit more of a walk in the park, but the LC comeback might be on the cards. Who knows? Let's see if they can keep this up. Obviously, the opening pick there will be helping them out, but still taking their time, and virtus.pro showing very little of their hand just yet. But 50 seconds left, they're going to have to start making their minds up, start that final bit of execution. Taz is going searching. Not going to find too much just yet, but on the next corner there could be a couple of kills waiting. Apex is ready, Uzi is ready. Flash comes out. Where they go for it, the smoke's in place. Apex not able to hop up. This could be a mistake, but where is Apex right now? Spraying down through the smoke, no connections. Uzi though, will be ready, will be waiting. Kelly as well, but Neo still fights through, finds Uzi. And only Neo and Taz though left to do this. Player still in on that B side, is Happy. They know he's gonna be coming around this side, and there we go. Happy finds one, doesn't get the second. Neo keeps a little bit of hope alive, but the bomb going down. Right now, and there we have it. Maniac makes his way through those tunnels, and LDLC claim another round. And
yeah,
take me
well
through
played.
That execution in mid there. Was that a mistake
from virtus.pro,
or just well played by
well
LDLC?
Well played by LDLC. Look, like I said, they had to do something. They were a man down early, so that, you know, they grouped up together. They knew that LDLC would be playing the sides because they had a man up. They were going to force them into their crosshairs, if you will. And you know, great work there by Apex. I think he just threw one flash that was perfectly timed, that just slowed him down as they were executing it. And that hurts when you're ready to take, you're ready to bust out for the boys, if you will, for your mates, and just like that, you're blind. So you have to take a step back, which allows the CTs to regroup and you know, mow them down as they did.
Wow, and look at Apex. You can't ignore this man. Straight up mid, no messing around. Wants to really rub a little bit of salt into the wound there, but he will eventually go down to Bialy. But ready and waiting is Happy to peek out, get to, and this is a nicely played out round from LDLC, trying to keep it as clean as possible. But Pasha, he's fighting it. He's fighting this as much as possible, but Kelly will close it down. And that scoreline, it's looking a little dangerous now.
LDLC are playing very well. I mean, there's a couple of rounds there, like I said, that it was theirs to lose. And,
yep,
and that's the difference. A virtus.pro, a fantastic team, they will capitalize. They will punish any mistakes made here by LDLC. And look, virtus.pro are the better team here, I personally think. Though, if they can't capitalize on these situations that they need to, this game is for anyone.
Well, at the moment, 28th round, 14-13. LDLC one round away from tying this up to a very even scoreline. But VODS.pro looking to maybe prove a point here, looking to find that real good execution. But Apex has adjusted. He's waiting, and he is ready. Gets down one. Looks for the second, not going to get it, but Uzi will. Taz goes down, and VODS.pro's push through mid once again has been halted. Uzi is not done just yet. Neo now in a 1v3, not going to get it. It's all even. That is just LDLC on point. They have worked out VODS.pro here.
Absolutely they have. Absolutely they have. I think right now VODS.pro would be a little bit worried. What they were relying on, and unfortunately, it's tough to say, but Pasha was the one that was keeping him in this. He was making some great plays early on in the first half and the second. And it's tough to rely on one player when a team is playing so well. From what I've seen so far, LDLC looks so composed. They look so prepared. They've done their homework. Again, it's not over. That's the beauty of this game. That's the beauty of this level of competition. It's anyone's to take.
At the moment, LDLC are grabbing it with both hands. Happy once again. The confidence on a stage like this, on such an important next couple of rounds, they're still being that confident, still wanting that little bit of a bite to them. And they're getting it. We're yet to see really that from VODS.pro just yet. Obviously, just on the pistols here. Not going to be bringing out too much. You never know with these guys, but at the moment, Apex and Maniac ready and waiting. Get the lockdown and send them back. LDLC, 15-14.
That's an eco. They didn't lose any players there. That hurts for VODS.pro. Absolutely, that does. They got shut down on what was it, the round before when they had guns. And you know, LDLC are almost saying, you know, come at us. You know, we're not afraid. You know, we're ready to take you on. We know what to expect. And like I said, they do seem well prepared. And they're just making their shots. I mean, Kelly's having an absolutely fantastic game, just like Pasha was.
Certainly finding his form. 15-8 just on this half.
Great stuff to see what's going to happen this last round.
The current reigning champions of this VODS.pro. A little bit of a situation now. LDLC on map.
That's confidence. Point. What they're doing right now, I mean, that is confidence.
Let's see if it pays off. Snacks will be found. Uzi claims it. 4v5. No answer just yet from VODS.pro, and already that little bit of aggression, that little bit of confidence with LDLC seems to be paying dividend as they now look for the follow-up. They spot out Pasha, they know what's going on, the information flowing as Kelly goes in for the peak towards long. Not going to be too aggressive, wait for the flash in, and then goes for the peak, not going to claim it, and Molly getting a little bit warm under the feet, but having to back away there, but HP damage done. But look at these crossfires instantly. LDLC are setting these up in a couple of seconds.
That's what they need to do. They have that man advantage, though. Right now, from a player's point of view, VODS.pro are in the position they want to be in. I mean, Kelly's low HP now. He's got that AWP. He'll be playing a bit more nervous. He'll be sitting back a bit, so they can't rely on him right now to get that entry that he's been doing so well so far.
Let's see if VODS.pro can now capitalize on that fact, but Apex stands in their way between them and A, and right now LDLC on the verge of this, but Pasha and Taz keeping them in this. Will this go to 15-15? But let's find out. As Taz up on A, bomb on long, crosses over Pasha, but Happy is there to challenge. Happy finds Taz, it's all on Pasha now. 1v2, don't tell me he can do this. He gets the tag, he's not going to find, there we go, Pasha. 1v1, Kelly against Pasha, the two players who've stepped up phenomenally for their side.
I can't Pasha. Believe what I'm witnessing right here.
Oh,
wow.
Kelly!
Get out of
Kelly!
Here. Get
can out you believe of here. It? To secure the final kill in that round.
Oh no.
You said you wanted something special. It needs something special from these guys, and that is it.
Well done, LDLC, and how fitting for it to fall to Kelly and Pasha in that final round, one versus one. Kelly with a jumping USP headshot. Wow, that's great stuff. That's what we want to see. I mean,
We're lost for words, I think.
Well
and
done.
Someone who won't be lost for words is the Scoot. Please break this down for us.
Yeah, thank you, Pansy. What do you mean I'm never lost for words? I have no idea what she's talking about. Crazy, you know? But halfway through that second half, we were kind of like, oh, man, it's going to go to Mirage. VODS.pro is going to be up one because they were on that roll, right? After the pistol, second side, they were dominating. LDLC said, you know, not quite over yet. Our map pick, we'll show you why we picked it. and they sure did.
I'm really impressed by their CT half there. I mean, going down, losing the pistol round when only getting eight T rounds with the pistol, they looked kind of shaky there, but turning it around shows great moral for the team, and they have the chemistry. You see how happy they got, and they're in it to win it, actually. And just like we said, they needed to win those two, because next map, Mirage, it's going to be hard. It's going to be hard.
Yeah, I think VODS Pro, though, are going to be really disappointed. At 13-8 up, they were in absolute control. They gave away a 3v3 on B site, and Snacks had, actually made a couple of good picks. And it just looked like it was going to be, you know, it was going to go 14-8, and it didn't. LDLC got that round, and it was a bit of a surprise. Totally broke up the momentum, and just that was the tiniest little chink of light they needed to sort of get the belief going again.
Definitely. And you can see, I mean, if you give them a little bit of your arm, they take it all. So, I mean, they took the chance they had, and I mean, even though Pasha and your Snacks, like you mentioned, took some great picks inside B, kind of obvious positioning there from LDLC, you know, getting pretty much free frags, because that's the spot you normally stand, going in with AWP. Looked like the game was lost, they lost their momentum and the flow, but they come back, and it was really impressive they can do it, being down that much.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I thought there was a lot of clutch play as well, which I was really surprised with from LDLC. I would have thought in those situations, you'd probably back VODS Pro more, just because of the experience. But LDLC really held their nerve. I mean, KQLY was just insane throughout, and for him to get that winning clutch at the end, huge.
Yeah. It's going to be really good for the self-confidence going into Mirage, even though, you know, VODS Pro, their map choice. I mean, you can get VODS Pro a little bit until losing when being up this much as Terrorist on those two. And, you know, QPLI, you know, jumping with the pistol, getting a headshot, even though he's been low since the start of the round. On Pasha, that's just, it's moral-breaking, actually, and it boosts your moral for your own team to do that kind of stuff and keeps you going, putting in an extra level for yourself.
So, speaking of morale, you know, you have recently added a coach, a strategic advisor, I believe is what you guys are calling PETA. Other teams have done it. Fnatic has moved Devil Walk. Moment works now for this team, LDLC, in very much a non-just cheerleader management role, but literally talking to them about strategies, also obviously doing that role where you calm them down, you keep them focused whether you're winning or losing. Do you think that, like, that sixth man, as it's truly becoming now, is going to almost be a must-have? Because obviously VODS Pro doesn't have that yet.
I really think so. I mean, not only, you know, the tactics you're using is normally, you know, to have the players in game leader and the strategic advisor, if you want to say, or coach, whatever you want to call it. You have them going through it before the games normally. But what the coach or the guy standing behind can see actually is like flaws in your own game, pointing it out to the in-game leader who can change it, and flaws in the enemy's team gameplay as well, because you can see it. Even though you're standing behind your own team, you can see the flaws in their defense when you're attacking, you can see flaws in their attacks that people don't watch all five screens can see. So if you have knowledge for the game and you know, play it on a high level yourself, or you know, watch it a lot, it's really easy to see, and you can give the information to the players, and you know, that's really game-breaking in many times, to be honest.
Yeah, so it'll be very interesting to see.
Yeah, it's going to be the future for everybody, I'm certain of it.
I think with VODS Pro as well, we've got Taz, who's obviously got a big enough personality to be a coach and a player at the same time, I think.
Yeah, he's huge. Like, you know, you almost need that other guy to not be as emotional as your players, right? Good or bad, right? Yeah. Sometimes you get too pumped up. And like prime example would be right now, LDLC, they had a clutch, almost loss, comeback, but they have to calm it right back down. They're now going to walk into Mirage, which is very much VODS Pro's home.
Yeah, well, we were just looking at the stats there while we were talking about the coaching thing, and obviously you can see who was disappointing for VODS Pro, and it was Taz and Bialy, I guess, a little bit, but mainly Taz. I mean, you can see he's adrift at the bottom there, and he got off to a very poor start in the game. That's obviously been a factor in this, because when you have a 16-14 game, it's literally not even one or two frags is all it is, and that's how it's turned around. The guy that we highlighted at the start, Uzi, I thought he had one of his better games that he'd had in quite a while. He's highlighted as a weak link, but like I say, he generally tends to do pretty well on just two. You can see that he came up with a clutch there as well, like KQLY, you've got the all-important clutch there as well. Apex way out in front, which we kind of expected. But let's put that map into context now, and that is, ultimately, we said it was going to be close. We said VODS Pro hadn't played a lot of Dust 2, and they hadn't. And I think they're going to think, well, that was a bit of a lottery. it's all about Mirage, and I fully expect to see a very different VODS Pro on this map.
Yeah, same here. I mean, their team play on Mirage, it's just amazing, and they really utilize the individual strengths they have on Bialy and Spex as well. Even though they utilize them so much, they get the duels they want, they can go aggressive inside smokes, you know, winning rounds by themselves, and you see the team play coming up both on the CT half and the T half. That it's like their home ground, this map, to be honest. I would not want to play them on it.
Yeah, and you look, you know, we've added all these new maps. So then you go, okay, well, did LDLC spend any time on Mirage, or were they worrying about time on Overpass and Cobble and those kind of maps? Because, again, paperwork shows that they haven't really played it much.
No, I mean, they've LDLC have been active in the Star Ladder at the moment, and they have played a few games on Mirage. Very mixed results, not a lot of wins, not a lot of show for it. I think that they're going to struggle on this, because Mirage is one of those maps where, because of the way it's structured, the rotations are so important. And that's about good communication and, you know, you've got to control mid. If you lose mid, you're going to lose the map. And I think VODS Pro have the players that can dominate mid.
And also, I think, you know, how it is for LDLC is probably, I'm just thinking out loud here, but probably they played it a lot, so they know Mirage, but probably haven't focused too much on it when having the new maps coming in. So probably, you know, yeah, we know this map well enough, but well enough is not going to be enough versus Virtus Pro's home map. So I think they're in for a tough game here.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, that being said, that kind of wraps us up for this little segment. So again, the next map, maybe the final map, if there's an upset in the making, it'll happen right here.
I really can't see it. I think this will be a comprehensive win for Virtus Pro. I'm thinking about maybe 16-4, 16-6. That's my take on it. Don't know about yours, Emil.
Actually, I think the only way LDLC can make this interesting and maybe even win the map is if they're, you know, Apex or Uzi really starting to shine individually, winning those clutch rounds as they did some here. But even more than this, that's the only way. Otherwise, 16-9 to Virtus Pro, depending on pistol round, 16-9, 16-10. Yeah.
And a totally separate question. Well, I got two questions for you while we're waiting for the players and everything. So first off, your take on the new maps.
Cobble. I'm not too big of a fan of Cobble. I mean, yeah, it's, you know, we played a lot back in 1.6. It was way too huge to start playing. You know, the round time when we played was, I can remember, was it 3:45 or something?
Yeah.
So you can sit in camp, rotate back and forth and everything. The map was good for that sense, because you had time to fake one bomb site, go back to the other, and, you know, getting picks. But with this round time, even though they added the new, you know, corridors and all the new exits and everything, for my taste, it's a little bit too big, actually. It's like, if you attack one bomb site, that's where they're going to come. It's kind of obvious. And I mean, on the other hand, Overpass, it's just amazing, in my opinion. I mean, it's a lot of, you know, the structure of it is like nothing else we've seen in Counter-Strike. It's, you see, you can boost up. There's no, what's it called? Skybox? What's it called?
Yeah,
so
like
you can throw nade. Yeah, exactly. So going into that map, I mean, right now the teams have been playing for, what, 1 month? And you already see some really cool boosts and nades and everything coming in. Can you imagine 1 year from now, people keep playing it? I think it's going to be probably the favorite map to watch games on.
Yeah, and really good point, because, you know, again, historically, most our maps are flat, right?
Yep.
And the old nuke, again, we don't necessarily love the new nuke as much, but again, that was one of its strengths, is we had stacked bomb sites. Yep. You have a verticality in your strategies. And Overpass kind of brings that with even kind of on steroids, because from some of the upper areas, you can see down below, you can kind of keep an eye on rotations. So, and again, that kind of seems to be the majority of the feedback is Cobble, too big, needs some work. Overpass, pretty solid in its structure, obviously some tweaks.
It is, and actually, you know, in Overpass, you can use your teammates, I mean, boost up over walls, both as C and CT, so you need to work together. Just going in an individual race is not going to be as profitable as it can be on, like, Dust 2, which is individual shining map, in my opinion, but you really need to work as a team there, flashing out for each other, having crossfires, boosting up on things. I love it.
And then, my other question, and again, we didn't see much of it in this map, but we've seen it a lot in CSGO. The use of the CZ, you know, people are starting to call this like CZ Go. And, you know, back in the day, you lose pistol, you absolutely are losing the next two rounds, probably. Like, it was almost a given. Yeah. And you would literally just throw it away. You almost didn't try. Unless occasionally you were, you know, complexity with their crazy deagle play. So, it's overpowered, right? So how would you fix that gun? Would you make it more expensive? Would you make it less accurate? Would you take bullets out of it? What would you do?
I think any of them are valid things to do. I mean, you need to be tuned down a little bit. I actually like, though, that you can win an eco round, that it's not like, yeah, you have two or three rounds for free after it. So it's actually some action going into it, and you never have a secure down. I mean, looking into Navi and Fnatic earlier today, 14-14 Nuke, and Fnatic have an eco to win it. And that I really think that enhances the experience of watching a game for the spectators and the players themselves. So I think it's a good thing, but then again, just like I said, it needs to be tuned down a little bit because right now it's way too strong.
It's like you said, it does make for amazing Counter-Strike, and it keeps you on your toes every round, which is awesome.
I think the thing that...
I'm cutting you off, sorry.
I think
this is the one time I'm cutting you off.
Oh, right,
you're in my ear. I don't want to get fired.
All right.
Folks, we're ready for map 2, possibly the last map, possibly not. Pansy Top Gun, take it away.